Welcome to Engineers Academy. Subscribe to my channel and click on the bell icon to receive the notification for the upcoming videos. Now we are going to solve this problem 235. So it is from 6th edition, and in 7th edition it is problem 238, right? So in this problem it is given that this force is applied at this gear. So then this force is applying 20 degrees with the tangent of this circle. Let's suppose this is that circle, right? So it is making 20 degree with the tangent, right? So then, and the radius of this gear is 100 mm, right? So we need to find the moment of this force about this point O, right? So as we see that this force is producing clockwise moment, right? So now what we need to do is that we need to resolve this force into its components. Let's suppose if I draw its component, so then this component is one component, right? And this is another component, right? So this component is the normal component and this component is the tangential component, right? So the normal component is passing through the point O, so it will not produce moment. So only the tangential component will produce the moment about this point O. So the moment about point O will be equal to F of t into the radius, that is the normal distance, right? So the normal perpendicular distance of this tangential force to the point O is radius r, right? So then f of t into r. So f of t is how much? So it is f cos of 20 degree, right, into r. So if we put value, so the f value is 60 cos of 20 into r. So r is 100 mm divided by 1000, right? So to get the answer in Newton meters, right? So what we get? So the answer is 5.64 Newton meter, and the direction is clockwise, right? So this is clockwise positive direction. So this is the solution of this problem, right? Now the next problem is problem 236. So it is from 6th edition. And in 7th edition, this the same problem is 235 problem, right? So in 7th edition. So now in this problem, it is said that calculate the moment of the 250 Newton force. So this 250 Newton force is given. We need to find the moment on the handle of the monkey wrench about the center of the bolt. So this is the center of the bolt. So let's suppose that this center of the bolt is point O, right? So we need to find the moment about this point O, right? And let's assume that this distance is d1 and this distance is d2, right? So d1 is 200 mm and d2 is 330 mm, right? And the angle with the vertical is 15 degrees, right? So we need to find the moment of this 250 Newton force about this O point, right? So we will resolve this force into its components. So let's suppose if I draw its components, so then this one will be the vertical component, and this one will be the horizontal component, right? So now we need to find these components. So let's suppose if this is the f of x component and this is the f of y component, right? So as we see that neither f of x is passing through the center of the bolt or neither f of y is passing through the center of the bolt, so both the components are producing moment about this point O, right? So then what we need to do is that we will write the moment about O, and as we see here that this f of x is producing counterclockwise moment, right? And f of y is producing clockwise moment about point O, right? And the perpendicular distance of fy from the center of the bolt is this d1, right? And the perpendicular distance of this fx from the center of the bolt is this d2, right? So then what we will do, we will write f of y into d1, right? And the f of y is producing clockwise movement, so this is our convention, the clockwise movement is positive, right? So what we will do, f of x is producing counterclockwise, so it will be minus f of x into d2, right? So then I will write, now what is f of y? So this is f of y. So the angle is made with the f of y component, so it will be the cos component. So then we can write f of y is 250 cos of 15 degrees, right? and into D1. So D1 is 200. 200 divided by 1000, right? Minus f of x. So f of x is 250 sine of 15 degrees into 30 divided by 1000, right? So we will get the answer in Newton meters. So when we solve this, so this is 46.33 Newton meters, right? So this is the solution of this problem. And this is, since this is positive, so we have considered that the positive direction is clockwise. So then this means that this is clockwise moment, right? And this is the direction. Now we are going to solve this problem 237, sixth edition. So in this problem, it is said that a mechanic pulls on the 13 mm combination wrench with the 140 Newton force shown, right? So this is a 13 mm combination wrench, and this is the 140 Newton force applied. Determine the moment of this force about the board center O. So we need to find the moment about this point O, right? So this will be the moment about this point O. So this will be counterclockwise, right? So the force is producing counterclockwise moment, right? So then let me draw the free body diagram. So let's suppose this is the positive x and y axis, right? And let me draw, let's suppose this is the OA arm. Let me write here, this is O and A. This is this OA arm, right? And the force is applied, the line of action of force is passing through point A, let's suppose so. So let's suppose if this is point A, right? So then if I apply force, so if I represent this force, so then this will be force. This is force making 25 degree with the vertical, right? Right, so if I draw a vertical line, so the angle between this vertical line and this force, this is 25 degrees, this is given, right? And this angle is also given, this is 15 degrees, right? Now, if I draw a perpendicular to this line from this same point, let's suppose if I draw a perpendicular at this particular A point, so now if I draw a perpendicular to this OA line, so it will be somewhere like here, like, so it will be somewhere here, right? This blue line, so this blue line is perpendicular to OA arm, this is making 90 degrees, right? So this is force F equals to 140 Newton, right? And the whole angle is 25, right? And as we can see that this line is perpendicular to this x-axis, this positive x-axis, and this line, this blue line is perpendicular to OA line, right? So the angle between these two lines to which these perpendiculars are drawn, so the angle between these two lines is 15 degrees. So this means that this is also 15 degrees, right? So we have already learned this. So this is also 15 degrees. So this means that this angle is how much? This angle is 25 minus 15. So this angle is 10 degrees, right? Now let's suppose if this blue line is the tangential axis, let's suppose if this is the positive T direction, so if I write is positive T, and let's suppose if this direction is positive N direction. So now if we resolve this force along these two axes, so then what we will get, we will be able to find the moment of this force, right? So what if I resolve this force, so then this will be the F of T component, right? And this one will be the F of N component. This one will be the F of N component. So if I write, so then this will be F of N and this will be F of T component, right? So F of T component is perpendicular with the OA arm, right? And F of N is passing through this point O, right? So this means that F of N will not produce any moment. So only the F of T component will produce moment, right? So F of T will be equal to, the angle is made with this T axis, right? So this means that F of T will be the cos component. So this will be F cos of theta, right? So then this will be 140 cos of 10 degrees, right? So this is F of T. And the moment about O, assumption is that this clockwise direction is positive, right? So then moment about O, right? So in when we see, so this f of t is producing counterclockwise moment, right? So I will write minus f of t into perpendicular distance. So this is that perpendicular distance, right? So if I write minus 140 cos of 10 degrees into 95 divided by 1000. So we will get the moment in Newton meters. So this comes out to be 13.10 Newton meters, and this minus sign so shows that this is counterclockwise. So counterclockwise, right? So this is the solution of this problem. Now we are going to solve this problem 238. So this is from 6th edition. So it is said that as a trailer is stored in the forward direction, the F is equal to 500 Newton is applied as shown to the ball of the trailer hitch. So this is the ball of the trailer hitch and this force is applied. So we need to determine the moment of this force about point O. So we need to find the moment of this force about this point, right? So here we see that this force is producing counterclockwise moment, right? So let me draw the components of this force. So then this will be the vertical component, right? And this one will be the horizontal component. This one will be the horizontal component, right? So as we can see that this, let's suppose that if this component is f of y, right, and this component is f of x, right? So let me draw the x-axis as well. So this is positive x-axis and this is positive y-axis, right? So this is f of y and this is f of x. So the f of x, the perpendicular distance of f of x from point O is this 38 mm. Right, so this is the perpendicular distance. So if I join this line, if I extend this line, so this is the perpendicular distance. This is the perpendicular distance, right? This distance. So this is the perpendicular distance of this f of x. And similarly, the perpendicular distance of f of y is this from point O. So let's suppose if this is d1 and this is d2, right? So then what we will do is that we will find the moment about point O, right? And assume that this direction, clockwise direction, is negative, right? So then f of y into its perpendicular distance. So d2 is the perpendicular distance from f of y to point O, right? And f of y is producing counterclockwise moment, right? Like this. So then this is positive, right? And similarly, the f of x component is also producing counterclockwise moment, so it is also positive. So then I will write plus f of x into d1. So d1 is the perpendicular distance of this f of x from point O, right? So then f of y, so f of y is 500 cos of 30 degrees, right? And d2, so what is d2? d2 is 275 mm divided by 1000 plus f of x. So f of x is 500 sine of 30 degrees and d1. So d1 is how much? It is 38 divided by 1000, right? So we will get the answer in Newton meters. So the moment about O comes out to be 128.6 Newton meters, right? And the direction is counterclockwise, right? Counterclockwise. So this is the solution of this problem 238.